moderez această sesiune. Aș vrea, în primul rând, să urez și un cald bun venit participanților din străinătate, cărora le dedicăm această secțiune. Și, de asemenea, aș vrea să dau citire numelor și tematicii comunicărilor, urmând ca după aceea să intrăm în discuții și ulterior dezbatere. Cu rugămintea să sperăm că fiecare comunicare va fi echilibrată și ca timp, pentru că vom avea și traducere, înțeleg.
Nu, va fi la
primul vorbitor înscris este domnul dr. Alexandru Stălcani, de la Institutul de Slavistică al Academiei Ruse de Științe Federația Rusă, cu o comunicare legată de probleme ale relațiilor URSS și Iugoslaviei cu România în notele de convorbire ale liderilor sovietici și iugoslavi 1945-1964. Va urma domnul dr. Ion Șișcanu, de la Institutul de Istorie al Academiei de Științe a Moldovei, cu o comunicare dedicată foametei din URSS în anii 1946-1947, între starea de fapt și coordonatele istoriografice post-sovietice. De asemenea, doamna dr. Elena Negru, de la același institut cercetător în cadrul același Institut de Istorie al Academiei de Științe a Moldovei, având o comunicare despre contactele umane dintre RSSM și RSR sau mitul prieteniei frățești și piatra din sân PCM, anii 1960-1980. Nu în ultimul rând, aș vrea de asemenea să vă comunic prezentarea domnului președinte Dinu Zanfirescu în dubla sa calitate de reprezentant în cadrul CNSAS și a Institutului pentru Investigarea Crimelor Comunismului, Memorii și Memoria Exilului Românesc, cu o comunicare legată de cercetarea exilului românesc din perioada regimului comunist, realizat
despre exil.
Mai mult despre exil. Bun, am înțeles. Cu permisiunea noastră, o să dau microfonul domnului dr. Stălcani pentru prima comunicare. Vă rog.
Mulțumesc frumos pentru invitația. Батай префет успекил, ваш бекос май Романия не знал, не знал, гуд. In the recent years, the Russian state archive of contemporary history, which includes the dossiers from the former archive of the leadership of the Communist Party of the Soviet Union, realized some very important publication projects concerning both the internal and external policy in the USSR after Stalin. We may mention the three-volume edition of the records and the resolutions of the of the meetings of the presidium of the Soviet Communist Party Central Committee in the years of Khrushchev. We may mention also the volumes of documents concerning the 20th Congress, the dismissal of Khrushchev in 1964, and the reaction of the international communist movement, the Soviet policy during the political crisis in Central Eastern Europe, especially the Hungarian crisis of 56 and the Czechoslovakian crisis of 68. Now we have prepared the first volume of the three volume publication project, the records and of the international communist conferences after Stalin, and we'll discuss about other projects which we are preparing now in this archive. This is the publication of the records of the meetings of the Soviet and Yugoslavian leaders after Stalin, when the relations of the communist regime or these two communist regimes began to improve. The first volume will be prepared till the end of this year. And it includes the documents since the 54-55 when the relations of two communist regimes began to improve after the death of Stalin and till the end of the 70s. It's important to speak about this here in Romania because the problems of Romania and Soviet Romanian relations, especially since the early 60s, were very, very, discussed during the meetings of the Soviet and Yugoslavian communist leaders. It's important to say that the Titoist communist regime in Yugoslavia, which resolutely opposed the Stalin's pressure in 1948, gained international authority and influence, and not only in the international communist movement, but also outside. It conducted independent foreign policy, played its own game on the contradictions between the United States and the Soviet Union, and became one of the initiators of non-aligned movement. It was considered in Moscow to be the incarnation of an alternative concept of socialism as a potential source of split and as some kind of challenge to the Soviet ideological predominance in the international communist movement, especially as the Yugoslavian model was popular among the reformist communists in Eastern Europe in the 50s. The neutralization of the alternative Yugoslavian influence on the Soviet and East European communists was considered in Moscow to be an important task, and therefore the relations with Yugoslavia were one of the priorities for the Soviet foreign policy, not only in the 50s, but also in the 60s, when the support of Marshal Tito was important for Moscow in the struggle between the USSR and China for the dominance in the international communist movement. As we see from the reports of the meetings of the Soviet and Yugoslavian leaders in the 50s, early 60s, the problems of Romania were discussed. First of all, in the last year of Khrushchev activities as the Soviet Party first secretary, and it is clear because in that concrete period in 63-64, the growing independence of the Romanian foreign policy cost more and more and of the Soviet Party. First of all, in the period of the Hungarian Revolution, Romania was in the focus of the attention both of the Soviet and Yugoslavian communists during their meetings. The deportation of Imre Nagy and the members of his team to Romania after the departure from the Yugoslavian embassy in Budapest created, as we know, new complications in the Soviet-Yugoslavian relations. In this situation, the Romanian leaders tried to mediate between Belgrade and Moscow. In Moscow, as early as in February 57, and attention was paid to the fact that the Romanian leaders tried to keep distance from the critics of Yugoslavian communists, in contrast with some other parties. It may be explained by the desire of the Romanian communist leaders to broaden the sphere of maneuvers in the situation when, after the Hungarian events, both Moscow and China made the main accent on the unity of the communist of the international communist movement, acting the differences and the specifics of various countries in contrast to the ideas of the 20th Congress. It may be noted that Gheorghe Udeș did not come personally to Moscow in November 57 to take part in the broad international conference. He expected that a new international anti-Yugoslavian campaign could be organized, because Yugoslavs beforehand rejected to sign the declaration of the conference. The Romanians valued good relations with Yugoslavia and preferred to preserve them even in the case of the new anti-revisionist campaign. As it is known, in June 63, a sharp conflict took place between Khrushchev and Gheorghe Udeș. It was caused, first of all, by the differences in their views on the prospects of their socialist economic integration. But during the talks between Khrushchev and Tito in August 63, the relations with Romania were not actively discussed. I think that Khrushchev was, in that concrete period, he was sure that temporary tensions with Romania could be overcome, and it is not worth to speak with the leaders of non-aligned Yugoslavia about the contradiction in the Soviet bloc. But in the next year, the situation was other. Principally, the Romanian Communist Party declaration of 1964, and especially the activization of contacts of Romanians with China, especially the change of opinions with China on the problems of Bessarabia, increased the Soviet anxiety with the Romanian deviation from the general line of the communist movement. On June 64, there was the four-hour meeting between Khrushchev and Tito, and the half of the talks was concentrated on the Romanian external policy. During the talk with Tito, Khrushchev expressed his displeasure with the fact that the Romanians underestimated the Soviet help in the building of the Romanian heavy industry. He was insulted with the fact that they criticized the quality of the Soviet goods exported to Romania. He was especially hurted by the fact that the Romanians used an anti-Soviet propaganda, the fact that in the previous year, when there was low harvest in the USSR, Romania gave the USSR a large amount of grain. The next year, this debt was reimbursed. Khrushchev also was very indignant that Romanians touched with the Chinese the problem of Bessarabia. He told Tito that he proposed Romanians, in particular Maurer, during the meeting to organize a referendum on the future of Bessarabia. Khrushchev assured Tito that the Soviet Union didn't impose on other countries the participation in the integration economic projects and did not object the active contacts with the United States and other Western European economies. He told Romanians about it. He also tried to disprove affirmations that the Soviet Union exploited other socialist countries and was responsible for the low living standards. Moreover, he considered his own merit the liquidation of joint Soviet-Romanian petrol company and other enterprises unprofitable for the Romanians, and he noted that it was he, Khrushchev, who proposed Romanians stop building the channel between Duna and the sea. According to Khrushchev, the Soviet Union bears the main load in integration projects and loses much because its trade with socialist countries is based on privileged conditions for them. Tito paid attention that Khrushchev was well informed of the internal situation in Romania. In particular, he spoke Yugoslavians about growing influence over Ceaușescu in this period, during this contract. Khrushchev considered it to be important to speak with Yugoslavians about these problems, because the Romanians see in Yugoslavia the example of a communist country with independent policy. Tito assured Khrushchev that Yugoslavia did not take any efforts to encourage the Romanian external policy, and it didn't support this policy, especially as concerns the rapprochement with China, whose leaders threaten peace and security. Khrushchev scarcely was sincere when he told Tito that the socialist integration projects could easily manage without Romanians. He was really anxious that the other countries could follow Romanians in the independent policy. Khrushchev asked Tito to influence Gheorghe Udeș, and Tito promised during the meeting in June 64 to warn Gheorghe Udeș to evade the deterioration of the relations with the USSR. According to the note of the Yugoslavian foreign minister Koche Popovic, the Yugoslavians considered it to be useful to meet with Romanians and to discuss the problems of their relations with Moscow. As Koche Popovic put it in his note, the Romanians who enjoy the achieved independence in their relations with Moscow sometimes go too far In particular, they remind the Russians about all the territorial problems, first of all, the problem of Bessarabia. Popovich noted that it is important for Yugoslavians to warn Romanians to be careful, otherwise it may harm, first of all, the new Romanian, more independent foreign policy. The meeting didn't take place between Tito and Gheorghe Udeșe. As we know, Gheorghe Udeșe died in March 65. There was dismissal of Khrushchev, after the dismissal of Khrushchev and the death of Gheorghe Udeșe, the same problems continued to be actual. Now Mr. Buga will cite one of the documents which will be published. He will speak in Romanian. The analysis of the Yugoslavian foreign ministry concerning meeting of the Yugoslavian and Soviet delegations in June 64, when the problems of the Romanian external policy was discussed.
Am impresia că în ceea ce ne privește am putea întreprinde ceva, deoarece pe baza informațiilor de care dispunem, românii, care acum se desfacă în noua lor stare de independență dobândită, în multe privințe exagerează sau în sarcau. Înainte de toate, națiunea că ridică în zadar multe probleme vechi ale relațiilor cu rușii. Acest lucru trebuie făcut pentru a nu pierde fondul pozitiv existent în tendința României spre o mai mare independență, spre relații egale în drepturi. Dacă nu vor exagera, aceasta va fi în folosul proceselor pozitive în relațiile dintre țările socialiste. Cred de asemenea că nu este exactă afirmația lui Khrushchev că România acceptă tot mai activ tezele chinezești, adică se plasează pe aceleași poziții în multe probleme serioase care constituie obiect de dispută. Altceva este faptul că românii abordează prea obiectivist, în ghilimele, această dispută și anume se pronunță insuficient împotriva tezelor chinezești. Ei probabil doresc în felul acesta să-și extindă spațiul de manevră împotriva rușilor și de aceea se abțin să pronunțe deschis împotriva conceptelor generale ale chinezilor.
Mulțumesc frumos! These documents will be published in the next year. There will be very interesting documents concerning the reaction of the Soviet and Yugoslavian party leaders on the external policy of Romania in that period.
Okay. Thank you very much, Dr. Alexander Stikalin. O să dau cuvântul la domnului Dr. Ion Șișcanu.